Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're talking about simple multiplication and its meaning. I want to start off by thinking about 2 add 2 add 2 add 2 add 2 add 2 add 2, and I want to represent that for us. So let's have 2 here, and we're adding another 2, and we're adding another 2, and so on. So this one, this one, this one, and this one. Now, how much have we got? Well, we could count it up individually and say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we know the answer to this problem is 14. Another way of writing this, how many 2s have we got? Can you see this is a 2, another 2, a 2, a 2? How many have we got? Well, we've got 7 lots of 2. So 7 lots of 2, and we know the answer is 14. And the way a mathematician writes 7 lots of 2, they write 7 times 2, or 7 multiplied by 2, or the product of 7 and 2 is 14. So this here is the mathematical word to mean lots of, and what it helps us do, it helps us do repeated additions quickly. So it's a way of writing, instead of having to write 2 add 2 add 2 add 2 7 times, we can just say 7 lots of 2, or 7 multiplied by 2 with the symbol 7 times 2. So that's what multiplication is all about. It's basically a way of helping us to do repeated addition quickly. Right, let's have a go at doing some. So here's example 1. Imagine someone asked you what 2 multiplied by 3 is. I want us to show it in a picture first of all. So 2 multiplied by 3 means 2 lots of 3. So here's 1 3, okay, here's another 3, and 2 lots of 3 are clearly equal to 6. Okay, alternatively, I want you to consider this. Have a look at this. Let's see if it mattered what order we did our multiplication. Let's say we did 3 multiplied by 2. Now, what does that mean again? It means 3 lots of 2 this time. So let's have a go at doing that. So here's 1 lot of 2, 2 lots of 2, and 3 lots of 2. And you can clearly see, if I put that together there, you can see in both cases we're getting the answer 6. So the order in which we do our multiplication doesn't matter. And I wonder if we can remember the word for that. We talked about this with addition. Multiplication is, and the word is, commutative. So that means we can do multiplication in any order, and that's going to be really, really useful in future, and it's something I really want you to work hard on remembering, that word and what it means. How would 2 times 3, how could that be said or written so we are familiar with seeing it in textbooks or hearing it from our teachers? Well, it could be 2 times 3, or 2 multiplied by 3, or the product of 2 and 3. And sometimes you might even see it 2 by 3, and you may even see it 2 lots of 3. So all those ways there mean 2 times 3. What does it look like on the number line, this? Well, it means 2 lots of 3. So you all will start with a multiplication. You're starting at 0, aren't you? And what you're doing is you're counting 3 2 times. So we're going up to 3 here 1 time, and we're going up to here, and we get the answer 6, as was here. What would 3 lots of 2 mean? Well, that would mean, again, you're starting at 0, aren't you? And what you're doing here is you're going up in steps of 2, but you're doing 3 lots of that. So we're going to go 1 time, 2 time, 3 time. And you can see we get to 6 again. So that proves again to us that multiplication is commutative. Right, I'd like you to have another go on your own. I'd like you to work out 5 multiplied by 3, write it another way if you can, fill in the missing word here about what multiplication is, tell us how 5 times 3 can be said or written, and show the answers that you've got for the different methods on the number line. I'm going to show this in a few seconds. 5 times 3 means 5 lots of 3. So let's get 1 lot, 2 lots, 3 lots, 4 lots, and 5 lots. And if you count them up, you get yourself the answer 15. Now, we could, because multiplication is, we've learned, is commutative, we're also going to try and work out 3 multiplied by 5. Now, what does 3 multiplied by 5 mean? It means 3 lots of 5. So let's take 5. Here's 1 lot, 2 lots, and 3 lots. And you can see that these are worth exactly the same amount. Again, it's 15. And because multiplication is commutative, we've got ourselves the answer 15. How would you write 5 multiplied by 3? Well, you could write 5 multiplied by 3. 5 times 3. 5 lots of 3. You could write 5 by 3. The product of 5 and 3. The product of 5 and 3, like that. There are some of the ways you could write it. And what does it look like on the number line? Well, we always start at 0. It's repeated addition. It's 5 lots of 3. So we're going to go up in 3's. So 1 3, 2 3's, 3 3's, 4 3's, and 5 3's. And we get to 15 just like we thought. Let's do it the other way around and just check it's the same by going up 3 lots of 5. So we're going to start at 0 and we're going to go up 1 lot of 5. We're going to go 2 lots of 5 and we're going to go 3 lots of 5. And we get ourselves 15 like before. Okay, have a go at this question. You may want to pause the video. And I just want you to convert these into mathematical symbols and work out the answers. I'm going to go through now. 2 times 3 means 2 times 3, that's how you would write it. 2 lots of 3 are 6. 3 lots of 2, well, that would be 3 multiplied by 2, which, because multiplication is commutative, is also 6. The product, when you see product, you know that means multiply. So the product of 8 and 2 means 8 multiplied by 2. Okay, so it means 8 lots of 2. You could also think of this, if it's easier for you to think of this in terms of 2 lots of 8. 8 and another 8, and both of those are going to give us 16, so either of those is going to help us out. 6 by 4 means 6 multiplied by 4, and 6 multiplied by 4 is 6 lots of 4, or you could work it out by 4 lots of 6. Either way, you get the answer 24. And I just want to finish by consolidating this and make sure we've absolutely got our links for future learning. Multiplication, the word I really want you to remember is multiplication is commutative. And that's brilliant. That means that we can do our multiplication in any order. Now, 2 times 5 means 2 lots of 5. And 2 lots of 5, 2 lots of 5 are 10. Or we could think of it as 5 lots of 2 if we reversed it, 5 multiplied by 2, which again is 10. The ways of saying this, I'm just going to call them out just so you can double check. It's 2 multiplied by 5, 2 times 5, 2 lots of 5, the product of 2 and 5, 2 by 5, and 2 times 5. So there are all the ways you could say that or hear that. On the number line, what does it mean? Well, this one here, it means you're starting at 0 and you're going up in jumps of 5 twice. So 1 jump, 2 jumps, you get to 10. If we were doing it the other way and 5 lots of 2, you start here and we're going up in steps of 2 5 times. So 1 time, 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, you end at 10 like before. And that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching.